Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. I'm really excited to be filming on my beauty channel again. I had kind of taken a long hiatus because I wasn't really wearing makeup for a while there. I was pregnant and nursing, and then life happened, of course, so that kind of interfered with filming. If you guys are interested in that, I talk about that more on my Hailey Homemaker channel. But I also made a pact with myself 2 years ago that I wasn't going to buy any more makeup because, quite frankly, I was becoming a hoarder. So I really cleared out my stash and I've used a lot of samples and a lot of products that I had. So now I am purchasing some makeup again as I need it. And so I've got some brand new favorites to share with you guys today. These are all high end. If you guys want to see a drugstore favorites of current stuff that I've been using, feel free to thumbs this video up. Also, if you're new, subscribe because that shows me that you guys like these videos and I love doing these types of videos. So if you guys are interested in seeing my high end favorites, keep on watching. Just real quick, if you hear any noise, my son is in here playing with some Scentsy testers, but I'm gonna go ahead and jump into skincare. The first product that I've been using again is the Fresh Rose Cleansing Foam. I absolutely love this stuff. Now, this isn't good for taking makeup off, I will tell you that, but I love this for the morning just to kind of refresh my skin and just wash off any like excess oil that, you know, happens during the nighttime. It's great to refresh your skin right before doing makeup. When I started using this, I was pregnant and I got so many compliments, and this is a little bit of a pricey face wash, but I absolutely love it. I feel like it makes my skin more luminous. I feel like it just makes everything just look glowy and delicious. So I highly recommend this face wash. A new face wash that I have been using at night is the Ole Henriksen. This is the African Red Tea Foaming Cleanser. Now, this is an anti-aging foaming cleanser, and being 32, I need to maintain what's going on up here. And so this is another foaming facial cleanser, and I really feel like this stuff is amazing at washing makeup off. I use this in conjunction with my Clarisonic brush, but if I don't have it in the shower, like if it's charging or something, it still washes everything off amazingly. And I use the Their Real Mascara from Benefit, and that's like a semi-waterproof product, and so definitely I have a hard time washing that off. I think everybody has a hard time washing that off, but this stuff just literally melts it off of my lashes, so I love this stuff, and I can really see a difference in my skin. I was breaking out in my chin area from stress, and with these two, I feel like my skin has really cleared up and it just looks a lot better. So another skincare product I've been loving is the Marc Jacobs Primer. This is the, I believe, the Coconut Primer, and I love this stuff. This is just really nice. I tried it on the back of my hand at Sephora, and I just noticed that it filled in all the lines on my hand, so I was like, if it's filling in all the lines, it's going to fill in any pores or lines on my face. Now, I have to tell you, the first time I used this, it felt a little bit heavy. If you just put it on the back of your hand and dab it on your face and rub it in, it definitely feels heavier. And so I don't like to fill my makeup. So what I do now is I use the Wet Beauty Blender and I just dab into it and I just blot it onto my face, and especially into the areas where I have pores, and it does the trick and it doesn't feel heavy at all. So I love this stuff. I feel like it really works great at making your skin just look just so pristine. So I'm really happy that I purchased this. Speaking of the Their Real Mascara from Benefit, that's one of my favorites. I've repurchased this recently. I had a ton of mascara samples that I was trying to use up, and so once I did, I went back out and purchased this again because this is probably one of my all-time favorite mascaras. It stays in place. When I perform, I don't get black under my eyes because I'm a DJ and a singer, and so I can sweat and tend to get black under my eyes, and this one really does fabulous. Hi, babe. You want to say hi? Come here. Oh, thank you. Say hi, come here. Say hi, everybody. Say hi, I'm Tristan. Tristan, say hi. Say hi, I'm Tristan. Say hi, I'm Tristan. I'm one of Mama's favorites. So another item that has been doing fabulously for performing, oh my gosh, you guys, if you have not tried this, this is the birthday gift for Sephora this year. This is the Marc Jacobs liner, and I got it in black. So I just love the packaging, first of all. It's so sleek. I also love that you don't have to sharpen this. It just twists up from the bottom to kind of, you know, give you more product. And this stuff is amazing. If you wear this in your waterline, again, everything that I've ever tried, I mean, I have some favorite drugstore products, but they do end up creeping down here by the end of the night. This one does not, and it stays in your waterline, and it stays really black for hours. So this is my all-time favorite liner now. I don't think I can ever go back to anything else. I'm also a contact lens wearer, and it does not transfer onto my lenses. So for those of you guys that wear contacts, this is definitely a great eyeliner to have. Another eyeliner that I recently purchased that I'm loving so much is the Sephora Colorful Wink It. It's Wink It Felt Liner. This is waterproof. Now, I was a little bit weary because I do have a MAC liquid liner that just stays on my lashes for like days. I'll like scrub it off and it does not come off with any cleanser. So I was afraid for this one, but this one has a very fine tip. And this is so great for precision if you want to create a wing of any sort. And it definitely stays put, but it also washed off with ease in the shower. So I was really happy about that. The other thing is that they have a ton of colors to choose from. They have this beautiful like periwinkle color that I had my eye on. And this eyeliner I think was either $14 or $18, but I really, really like it. And I feel like you can create such a thin line if you want, or you can make a really dramatic wing and it's really dark and stays in place. So the next item that I've been getting a ton of compliments on and I'm actually not wearing today, go figure, is the MAC Silver Dusk Highlighter. So this is a loose powder. Every time I wear this, I get asked what it is that I'm wearing. This is an amazing highlighter, but I like to put something kind of underneath it to give it just a little more sheen. This stuff just looks so beautiful on fair skin. I feel like it just gives you like a natural glow. So I really like it a lot. I mean, it's probably one of my favorite high-end highlighters besides Mary Luminizer, but I don't know if that would really be considered high-end. It's a little more affordable, and that's the one I'm wearing today, and you can get that off of Hot Lip. And another item that I did purchase is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit. It looks like this, and it comes with different shades. In particular, I like these two shades right here, and then it also comes with some highlight shades. It comes with a banana color that you can use under your under eye area to set concealer. That is honestly not one of my favorite colors. I feel like it's too yellow, but as far as contouring, I love these two. This one I like a lot for my skin tone, but I just kind of dab into both. This one's just a little too orangey brown for me, but what I like about this palette is, as you can see, there's little indentions right here, and you can literally, and I don't want to break my nail, but you could lift each little pan out of there. So if you run out of one color, you don't have to go buy an entire palette. You can just order that color online and it'll go back in like magnetically. So I love that. I feel like this is a great palette to have on hand, and I definitely use it every day. And last but not least, I've talked about this palette a ton here on this channel. This is the Steel Soul palette. This is from Sephora. I absolutely love this palette. I feel like it's so great. It's got a huge mirror, as you can see, and it's just got a ton of colors, and you can see that I've hit pan on quite a few. So the colors that I actually use a lot is this one right here, and this one's called Light. And then I use this brown a lot. This is the perfect transition shade, and this is called Heart. And then I use this top one to kind of darken my crease, and that is called Being. So I like that they have the little diagram here on the back with all the names. But yeah, so I'm going to be really sad when this brown finishes. I'm going to have to see if they sell that separately. But I feel like, you know, this is a great palette to go from day to night. So if you're like at the office and then you're going to go on a date and you want to vamp it up, you can kind of pull this palette out and just kind of touch up your crease, darken it up. And then there's also Kitten in here. So if you want to add a little bit of highlight for some nighttime, you could even use this as a highlight because it's very goldy and shimmery, and if you want to just add a little bit of gleam to your face, this palette is definitely so versatile and I love it so much. I don't think I've ever used a palette as much as I've used this, and that's saying a lot because I really like to experiment with my makeup a lot. But that is the end of my high-end favorites that I've been currently using. Again, if you want to see a current drugstore favorites, feel free to thumbs this up. Also, if you guys have any requests for this beauty channel, I am looking for those. Leave them down in the comment section below, and I will get on top of that. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye!